Thank you, and you know, it said simply one thing: share a presentation that you love about. And I'm like, all right, that's easy. So here I am. million people. These are not the statistics that you're seeing. Is not from 17th or 18th century. This is like right now. 21 million slavery and 4.5 million people are women and children. Just let it sink in for a second. That's the population of New Zealand that we're talking about. Women and children exploited. Why? When I was in Nepal, a guy approached me asking how many girls you want for how many nights, what age group, and his range was 12 to 16. And that really made that, you know, got me into that outrage, like, who are these people? And why are they exploited? And what can I do about it? So I came to New Zealand, and I wanted to be their voice. I wanted to scream out loud. And that's what I did. I ran the length of New Zealand on the Te Aroha Trail, not just running it, but it was in winter, and in two pairs of jandals. But during that trip, I got an amazing opportunity to scream out my voice. When people ask, why are you doing it? I could be the voice of these people to say why I'm doing what I'm doing. And ended up raising $7,000. But most importantly, it was all the awareness. There was Tim Shadbolt, the mayor of Imakagi, who got to the finish line just to see who the skinny Indian is who's doing it in sandals in winter. Brought him on board. Then I was thinking, it was my adventure. I wanted people to be a part of this adventure. People to opening someone's wallet was the easiest part. Opening someone's heart was the toughest part. So I wanted to partner up with people and go on an adventure with people. So, January 15th, I went on an adventure on a tandem bike named Kindness to Cape Reina to ride the length of New Zealand, picking up people along the way. Strangers and friends, 3,330 kilometers to help me pedal for a cause. Tell me your name and what's your story, and I'll tell you why I'm riding in the first place. Why tandem bike? We are talking about freedom, and I wanted to give people a taste of what it means to not have that freedom. You cannot steer your bike, you cannot stop when you want to stop, and you're trusting a random stranger who's asking, hey, want to go on an adventure? Honestly, I thought they were going to call cops on you. But that's what happened. When I was standing there, with a lot of doubts and uncertainties, I'm like, Naresh, there's still time, go back. This is not going to work out. So when I asked the couple to take that picture, and they took the picture just to mark my adventure. And what happened next was magic. I was standing at Cape Reinga asking who's gonna go on an adventure with me. It happened in that sequence. The couple took that picture, then they said, that's a really cool bike, we wanna take a picture with your bike. I took a picture of them, and the next minute when I was rushing away, they said, where's your passenger? And I said, will you be my passenger to help pedal for a cause? He immediately got on the bike, gave the keys to Linda, and met 30 kilometers away from her, and he gave $400 donation and drove 30 kilometers. Why did he do what he did? Because he felt the cost. When you push your limits, when you go back home with your achy muscles, it's not recreation, adventure, or fitness, but you pedal for a cause. That was a 65-year-old walking her dog. I picked her up, and I picked her dog as well. That was a coffee guy who was making coffee on the side of the road. That was a lady from Filipino making coffee on the ride. She didn't know how to ride a bike. She's covering up her fear by smiling the entire way. Construction workers who gave me leftover pies and some Gatorade on the side of the road. An amazing Maori family who I crashed their party, took that guy for a 3-kilometer ride, gave me a hobby at the end of the day. And my cycle broke right in front of her driveway at 9 o'clock in the evening. She invited me home, went out of her way to help me. That boy gave me $5 after riding 3 kilometers, and I told him what $5 can do by showing him 393 rupees. I said, you may buy a bag of lollies, but in Nepal, 10 kids can go to sleep today because you fed them. And he felt empowered when he went to bed that day, that even at a 7-year-old, I can do something about it. And it came with its own problems, right? A lot of failures, 32 broken spokes. New Zealand sun is pretty serious. 85 SPF is useless. And lots of flats along the way. A challenge can be a real challenge, unless there's a possibility of failure, right? So there's a lot of challenges along the way, but that's what it's all about. But it gave me an opportunity. Every time they see that skinny Indian riding this bike with no one in the backseat, why are you doing it? And I got invited to schools, spoke to so many schools, libraries, and churches, and mobilized them, and they became my fundraisers while I was riding the bike in New Zealand. And an English boy who was riding in Kiwi Experience bus threw his backpack, jumped on the bike. A hitchhiker going to Rotorua, I said, you have to earn this ride. And 4-10-year-old Kiwi boys playing on the side of the road on a hot day, we jumped off a bridge 30 meters just to cool down, and they rode the bike with me. 3-year-old Holly, my youngest rider. 72-year-old Sarah, my oldest rider. And my friend and I, we went over the Crown Range from Cardrona to Queenstown in 1.5 hours. And I was sitting outside and eating at food at the New World. I didn't know where to go. 10 minutes later, I was sitting in a jacuzzi with a guy. Watching, binge-watching Friends back to back. And next day morning, I was having breakfast with a 3-year-old. She was drinking milk, I was watching coffee and watching cartoons. 140 people rode the bike with me. 3,332 kilometers. $42,000 raised. $20,000 was my goal. 6 lakhs, 1 tire, 34 spokes, 1 brake is failure, 2 crash, and 1 bruised ego. A girl saw me dropping and she asked me if I'm okay. I'm like, I'm okay, don't worry. All this to stand with her. All it takes for evil to triumph is for good people to not do anything. So my appeal, will you stand with her?